We are live, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us. The Drudge Report is linked to our article, 1984 arrives in America. And that's got the video press release of Janet Napolitano, the head of Homeland Security, the Homeland. I mean, this is so Orwellian in every case. It's as if they're using the book as a handbook. This is all about setting up citizen spies, the TSA being at all bus terminals, train stations, highways, inside schools. They've announced this years ago. Now they're rolling out at over 800 Walmart locations at the checkout counter. Janet Napolitano giving you messages about spying on other people shopping, training us to be spies, not to trust each other. This is all part of InfraGuard, Secure Corp. It's all part of the, quote, infrastructure protection. Meanwhile, our borders are literally wide open, especially the southern border, where there's been over 20,000, 28,000 now deaths in the last 2 years, more deaths than, again, per year in Vietnam, but they don't care. That's not the issue. They're here training us that basically anyone could be a terrorist and that the government's got to have this surveillance state in place and actual telescreens right out of 1984 on the street corners, on the billboards. Take the Schwarzenegger movie, The Running Man, with billboards saying report terrorist, big video billboards. In every dystopic book or film, this is the hallmark. Well, now in Walmart, and we've got falling prices and falling freedom and rising tyranny. I mean, this is out of control. And we have Homeland Security putting up billboard signs, handing these out in high schools, colleges, all over the country, these sheets that say, if you see something, say something, as if we're idiots. And I was talking to one of the guys in the office who works in sound equipment. And one morning was putting boxes in a truck with people, they're white guys. Can you imagine if they'd had brown skin? And a guy pulls up in a pickup truck with one of the bumper stickers that said terrorist hunting license and says, where are you going? What are you doing? What are you loading in there? And they said, sound equipment. And he goes, I'm just making sure you're not Al-Qaeda. So you've got a better chance of dying from a bee sting, over 100 a year die from that, than dying of terrorism. But they're saying spy on everybody, and now we're going to have government announcements being pumped through the telescreens at Walmart and other retailers, and California's announced they're coming out with digital license plates that have wanted signs on it and flashes government messages. And now the FCC, this is out of the Hill newspaper, pushes to regulate news, and they openly say they want to shut down talk radio and alternative media and censor the internet. And you're going to have to get government approval to have a talk show. They're just announcing it all. America is becoming East Germany. We first wrote about this months ago in June. Kurt Nimmo did. FCC stealth plan to censor internet content. Kurt's got a new report out. FCC to push to Sovietize broadcast media in America. I'm going to play a video clip of one of the top people in the FCC openly saying this. I mean, they're really going for broke. So, Homeland Security wants us to report on the terrorist and on who's corrupt. And they say, did you see something suspicious? Communicate to work. Again, it says, did you see something suspicious, commuting to work or grabbing some lunch? Then say something to local authorities to make it right. A federal announcement, and the TSA showing up on the streets of America, groping people. It's popping up on local news all over the nation, Texas, Florida, New York, Massachusetts, California. I mean, this is a federal takeover of society. They're recruiting citizen spies, you name it. And when you look at the MIAC and Homeland Security reports that we got more than a year and a half ago from good law enforcement, and it was later confirmed by mainstream media, Homeland Security admitted they'd done this, that the number one focus is gun owners, conservatives, and returning veterans. Now, if that isn't a creepy, authoritarian, out-of-control government acting like a bunch of villains, I don't know what is. So, Homeland Security wants you to report where you think terrorism is coming from. Well, we have Operation Northwoods. The mainstream ABC News has covered it. U.S. government plan to stage 9/11 style attacks. And we have Gulf of Tonkin admittedly being staged to get us into Vietnam. We have Fox News exclusive. Al-Qaeda leader dined at the Pentagon just months after 9/11. Anwar al-Awlaki, maybe the first American on the CIA's kill or capture list, but he was also a lunch guest of military brass at the Pentagon within months of September 11th. hanging out with the Secretary of the Army. So he was number three in al-Qaeda at the time. He's number one under bin Laden today. He handled the underwear bomber, the Fort Hood shooter. He literally runs these people, but then he's always protected, and then it turns out he's working with the U.S. government so they can take our rights. So shouldn't that be reported to Homeland Security? Shouldn't all the new NIST videos that have been released that show firemen talking about bombs in other buildings, or that show police saying, get back, they're going to blow up Building 7, shouldn't all that be reported to Homeland Security? So I'm going to call this public number. They've got this on telescreens at Walmart. They're handing it out at high schools, middle schools. They're handing it out at colleges. And so I'm going to call this public number right now on air. We're going to call Homeland Security right now, and I'm going to report to them who the real terrorists are, just like I did 2 months before 9/11 when I said, call the White House, call Congress. They're going to blow up the World Trade Centers and blame it on their asset, bin Laden. Remember that on record? Well, I'm going to call them now, and I'm going to report the crime here live on air. Go ahead and start dialing them, men. Says, did you see something suspicious commuting to work or grabbing some lunch? Then, you know, call Homeland Security. This is the Threat Fusion Centers. Give them something to do so they can find likely spies. Give me a document can shot here.
Hello?
Hey, this is Alex Jones calling. Is this Homeland Security?
It's not.
Is this?
The FBI.
It's the FBI. Oh, same thing. You're under the Homeland Security.
Can I help you?
Yes, we're broadcasting worldwide, and Walmart's putting in the telescreens. I wanted to report key information concerning the attacks of 9/11 and further attacks.
What's your information?
Okay, again, my name is Alex Jones, and I wanted to read to you open source material, exclusive. Al-Qaeda leader dined at the Pentagon just months after 9/11. Anwar al-Awlaki may be the first American on the CIA's killer capture list, but he was also a lunch guest of the military brass at the Pentagon within months of 9/11. And this is when he was on the news as a number three in al-Qaeda, meeting secretly with Pentagon brass, and he admittedly has run the Fort Hood shooter, the underwear bomber, all of these people. Kurt Haskell, the lawyer, on the flight back from Amsterdam, reported that he saw government helping him get on the plane. That was later confirmed by the Undersecretary of State, Mr. Kennedy, that an unnamed U.S. agency was ordered to help get the underwear bomber on the plane. I want to report the Pentagon and the U.S. government for their history of staging terror attacks, including the Gulf of Tonkin to start the Vietnam War. I want to report Operation Northwoods. I want to be able to send you the newscast that were live of the police saying, get back, that the government was going to blow up Building 7 on 9/11. So will you take my report here, or who can I call to report who the terrorists are?
I'll provide you with an email address. Hold on, please.
And see, everybody, they want to put us on list. They want to do all this. Call them all the time. We know who the terrorists are. We know who ordered the FBI to stand down and called dozens of FBI agents in Arizona, in Florida, and in Minnesota off of the terrorist. Are you back, sir? Because I'm here to report the terrorists since they've got telescreens going in at Walmarts. Hello? Broadcasting worldwide, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not putting up with it anymore. We need to get in these people's faces and let them know that we're fully aware who's staging the terror attacks. Doesn't matter. Worldwide polls already show 83% Angus and Reid, New York Times poll. Question the official.
Okay, sir, I'm back.
Official live 9/11. Yes, can I have your name, please?
I'm the duty agent.
The duty agent? Where is this particular threat fusion center located that I just happened to be dialed into?
I work in Atlanta, sir.
So this didn't geolocate to the Threat Fusion Center in Austin. It sent it to the FBI headquarters, or is this a Threat Fusion command base?
I don't know how you initiated your call, sir. I happen to be in Atlanta, and I'll provide you with that mailing address now if you're prepared to copy.
Yes. In fact, guys, can I have a pen? I forgot to get one. We are going to put that mailing address out. Please give us the mailing address.
P.O. Box 98128 in Atlanta, Georgia, and the zip code is 30359.
Can you give that to me one more time? Sorry, I'm writing.
P.O. Box 98128, Atlanta, Georgia, 30359.
Sir, you've certainly heard that Anwar al-Awlaki is behind all the latest terror attacks. Do you find it interesting? Do you think I should have called?
I'm not going to discuss that with you now. If you have any information we need to review, we would like to take a look at it. Just go ahead and mail it to that address.
So everybody should mail you Fox and AP that the top terrorist works for the government. Okay. Maybe he's hanging out at your office. Okay, thank you. I mean, hell, if he's at the Pentagon, why not be at your office? Okay, ladies and gentlemen. So, let me give you that number again for anybody out there that wants to call 877-428-5324. I mean, let's tell them where the terrorists are. Let's mail them disc with the CNN and all the other newscasts with the police going, get back. They're bringing seven down. Silverstein saying, yeah, we gave the order to blow it up and watch it come down. I mean, let's send it all to them. But see, it's all part of a little false power trip of how, oh, they're keeping America safe. Give me a break. Oh, and well, they care about the veterans as the government announces they're going to take their pension funds and their health care from veterans. New York Times tells us what a great idea it is. I want to finish up with the TSA information right now. This video, again, is linked up on the Drudge Report. Right now, if you go to thedrudgereport.com, it's the easiest way to find it. Just already scrolled off the front page on Infowars.com. It's TV monitors at checkouts with government message. You click on that and Drudge links to us. And it has 1984 arrives in America. You can see Big Sis's message, one of thousands to come, droning and giving us orders about how much the superstate loves us and how great the economy is and how wonderful and you know, the government loves us, but don't trust your neighbors. And under that, I have the headline, Walmart invasion, part of larger DHS takeover of America. We're going to go ahead and roll this 5-minute video. Then I'm going to come back and get into WikiLeaks. We got key intel on that. I'm Alex Jones, defending the Republic from enemies foreign and domestic. Mind control alert. Mind control alert.
Hi, I'm Janet Napolitano, Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security. Homeland security begins with hometown security.
Well, it's here. 1984 in America. This is the straw that breaks the camel's back. There is no doubt that we're in deep trouble as a society. The head of Homeland Security, Big Sis, Janet Napolitano, has now come out and announced that over 800 Walmarts in the next month are going to install telescreens at the checkout scanner with different federal orders to spy on the other people shopping.
That's why I'm pleased that Walmart is helping to make our communities more safe and secure. If you see something suspicious in the parking lot or in the store, say something immediately.
Homeland Security is putting up billboards all over the country that say if you see something suspicious, communicate it. Okay, well, I'm going to communicate something to you, Homeland Security. I see it suspicious that trillions of dollars have come up missing and the private Federal Reserve won't tell Congress where it's gone, and it turns out it's foreign banks and corporations. I find all the corruption in government that's growing out of control to be suspicious. No wonder you want to distract us with all your fables about terrorist boogeymen. For anybody who studied history, this is completely obvious. We are going into hardcore tyranny.
Report suspicious activity to your local police or sheriff. If you need help, ask a Walmart manager for assistance.
This is Big Brother on steroids. And folks, this is not a surprise to people that have been reading our sites because Homeland Security for at least 2 years has been on record starting these Viper teams and checkpoints in Boston and New York City and Miami. It's on the local news showing them doing the grope downs, grabbing people's genitals, patting them down on the streets of America. This is wrong on so many fronts. It's a violation of the 10th Amendment.
Our Tampa police and federal government agencies are teaming up to keep your family safe.
It's the sort of security we've seen a lot of since 9/11. Now, here at the bus station, it's all part of what Homeland Security calls Viper, for visible intermodal prevention and response.
This way, us and our partners are ready to move in at a moment's notice.
Folks, it doesn't get any more Big Brother 1984 than this.